Good evening, Mayor, members of council, Richard Joaquin, Parks Planning and Development Manager. I'm really excited to be delivering this presentation to you all this evening. This is a really exciting time for Parks and Recreation in Tracy. Staff's been working very collaboratively with the Tracy Hills team. Thank you all for attending tonight over there, Integral. And we've been working together for years now as it relates to subdivision planning in the case of this agenda item, specifically park planning. This item tonight involves the approval of design documents related to the Tracy Hills specific plan area. So for just a quick overview of what I'll cover this evening during my presentation, I'll start with a little background on the Tracy Hills project and other relevant information, and then I'll touch on the Tracy Hills Community Park and open space, including several specific items related to compliance with the developer agreement related to both of these. And lastly, I'll touch on next steps and then finish with some questions and answers. So just some quick background. In 1998, the Tracy Hills project was annexed into the city with approval of the Tracy Hills original specific plan and EIR. In 2016, Tracy Hills specific plan was updated with a new EIR and the Phase 1A vesting tentative map. 2020, Tracy Hills Phase 1B and Hillview areas were approved. In 2021, Tracy Hills Phase 2 was approved. And most recently, and really related to this item, just in September of this year, the Parks and Community Services Commission recommended approval of the Tracy Hills Community Park Conceptual Designs and Open Space Improvements Proposal to the City Council. Here's a map showing the Tracy Hills specific plan area to provide some additional context. On this map, you'll notice labeled Phase 2A, Phase 2B, Phase 3A, and Phase 3B. These are the areas within the development we are specifically dealing with tonight. You will hear me refer to the Phase 2 Community Park and the Phase 3 Community Park. Each of those park parcels fall within those respective areas on this map. So I'll start with DA compliance related to the community park. This slide highlights several key requirements the developer must meet related to the community park, aside from obviously the review and approval of the community park conceptual plans. That's the main focus of this, one of the main focuses of this agenda item tonight. For reference, these requirements are specifically related to DA section 4.2A. The developer must provide no less than 30 acres of new usable land for the community park. The community park land must also be located within the larger 180-acre open space area, including being well connected to the open space. The community park cannot be comprised of more than two net usable areas of at least 15 acres each. If these two areas are not contiguous, which based on the image shown here on the screen, you can see they clearly are two separate areas. They must be connected via an improved trail. As it relates to the community park design and construction, the following compliance is needed. Provide conceptual designs for Phase 2 and 3 community parks, as well as the linear connection. The developer must design and build the Phase 2 community park, and they must do so in no more than two phases. The timing of start of construction for each of these phases, as well as completion of those phases, is tied to the issuance of the 2,900th and 3,600th building permit. As a just for reference, as of tonight's meeting, the developer has currently been issued 2,069 building permits within their specific plan area. And lastly, the design of the community park must be consistent with the park's master plan. At this time, staff's recommendation to the Parks Commission and the City Council is that all of these requirements have been met. So moving on here, the image you see on the screen is the Phase 2 Community Park Conceptual Plan, designed by the developer and submitted to the city for review and approval. This park is approximately 16.25 acres in size. The conceptual design, as shown, complies with the developer agreement, including Parks Master Plan requirements in terms of site selection criteria, which is really the primary focus of this effort. This includes size of the park, frontage, access, connectivity and configuration, development capacity, natural areas, and open space. You can see some of the conceptual imagery shown here depicts various types of programs and amenities that are being contemplated for the park. This includes significant items such as a cricket field, which staff and the developer have been hearing a lot of interest from the community about, as well as a wiffle cricket area. It also includes a substantial children's playground, a skate park, a dog park, disc golf, a natural amphitheater, and concrete stage for a variety of events, a disc golf course, and more. A large majority of those amenities I just listed, you've probably heard dozens of requests for in the last several years. And this is something that, you know, really ties back to the park's master plan and helping to fill access gaps and programming needs for not just Tracy Hills, but for the entire community, which is why good collaboration with our development partners is so key to successful park planning. As previously mentioned, if the developer proposed to separate the community park into two areas, these areas would need to be connected via an improved trail, which is what's being shown on your screen now. The conceptual design here is that connection. Essentially, it's a greenway, or sometimes referred to as a green belt, green referring to the fact that it's heavily vegetated. This will be a tree-lined corridor with a multi-use pathway, raised pedestrian crossing, seating options, and stone arched promenade that is approximately 1,200 feet long and 40 feet wide. On the Phase 2 community park and linear connection conceptual designs, I do want to note that these are in fact conceptual, meaning that as staff and the developer continue to collaborate and work through more detailed planning, adjustments to the layout and to the program may occur, which leads me to my next slide. At this time, the developer has provided to the city a high-level concept for the Phase 3 community park. Represented on the screen is that high-level concept. It includes the size, frontage, access, and connectivity of the park in addition to some preliminary programming. A few key areas of missing detail is how this level of design is different than the Phase 2 community park design shown. Certain details such as the dimensioned walkways, space allocation for various programs and amenities within the park, and other refinements to the site planning process have yet to be worked out, and staff is okay with this at this time. This high-level concept does, however, still satisfy the critical site selection criteria just the same as the Phase 2 park conceptual plan does, which is why staff believes this exhibit meets the intent of providing conceptual designs for the entire Tracy Hills Community Park under the developer agreement requirements. Just briefly, I want to touch on something. This is on the developer proposed programming. So this includes programs such as a meditation garden, nature play area, a sloped play hill, a restroom, shade structures, picnic area and barbecues, beach volleyball, sport courts, and more. Staff's has clearly conveyed to the developer that we'd like the community park programming to be taken through a public outreach process. We want to ensure that the community has a chance to weigh in on this, as the last time a community park was constructed in Tracy was in the early 2000s, over 20 years ago, going back to Veterans Park and the Tracy Sports Complex. Community parks, compared to neighborhood parks, don't come around very often, which is why this is a really exciting time to be in park planning here in Tracy and an exciting time for the community. Staff also makes this recommendation to council based on the fact that it will likely be 5 or more years until the Phase 3 community park is constructed. So we want to ensure that the programming is not too locked in this far in advance of construction. This will give us the flexibility we need to ensure the park responds to the community needs at that time. Giving authority to your city manager will allow staff to continue the collaboration process with the developer as we move forward with this public outreach campaign and ultimately take in a much more refined master plan to the Parks Commission for approval. In an effort to better articulate the council and the public as to how big 30 acres is, I put this quick slide together. So how much fun can you fit into 30 acres of community park? Well, you can see here the list of our existing community parks. You know, you have El Pescadero Park at 14.6 acres, Lincoln Park, Dr. Powers Park, Gretchen Talley, all in that 11 to 13 range, Veterans at 15.8. So in this case, you can imagine, you know, two Veterans parks being developed in this area of the Tracy Hills subdivision, which is pretty substantial. And as previously mentioned in the background, the Parks Commission did make a formal recommendation for approval of the community park concept design to the City Council. So I'm going to move on now to the open space improvement proposal. And before I go into that, I think it's important to note that at one time, Tracy Hills was proposing a large 150-acre golf course within the development. And due to various reasons, that amenity has been removed. Staff at that time felt that open space or green space was really critical to the quality of life for the project and really advocated for the community to establish these requirements. The developer agreed to those requirements at that time, and this is really how these conditions were born. And I thought that was important to mention because these requirements are really going to translate to a significant new opportunity for parks and recreation in Tracy. So back to the slide here. This slide highlights several key requirements the developer must meet related to open space, the open space requirement. For reference, these requirements are specifically related to DA Section 4.3. The developer must provide no less than $1.5 million in improvements to a 150-acre open space area. They must also submit an open space improvements proposal, which is what was presented to the Parks Commission and also being presented to you tonight. This includes a design concept for the open space improvements and a proposed budget to confirm they meet the $1.5 million threshold previously mentioned. The developer must construct the open space in phases as development occurs. So this will continue to grow over time as the subdivision grows. And lastly, the developer is required to provide for the long-term maintenance of this open space area. This does not include the community parkland. The community parks will be city-owned and maintained, whereas the open space areas will be HOA-owned and maintained. On the screen now is the open space design concept. This exhibit shows graded open space as dark green and native open space areas in dark gray throughout the phase 2, 3, and 4 areas of the project. Various dashed lines show different trail types, and it also depicts the preliminary plan for various amenities the developer plans to provide throughout these open space areas and how they are connected to the park network. Staff has really engaged the developer to ensure the parks and open space are interconnected and really create a green network of parks, trails, pathways, and open space areas throughout the entire subdivision area. Based on this proposal, the community will have access to a variety of trails of varying difficulty that have never existed in Tracy before. This includes viewpoints overlooking the larger Tracy community and even views of the Sierra Nevada on a clear day. This is huge for the community, as we found through the Parks Master Plan update process that this community really does have an appetite for trails and open space, often traveling to the Bay Area and beyond to get high quality trails and open space, and now this is something that's going to be right here in our community. Here are several conceptual images depicting various improvements proposed for the open space area, including native soil trails, trail entrance features, shaded trail rest areas, art sculptures, fitness stations, lookout points, a 10-foot wide decomposed granite trail, and informational signage. As previously mentioned, the developer is required to provide 150 acres of open space. However, based on their proposal, they're planning to provide approximately 226 acres on 30 HOA-owned parcels. Approximately 80 of those acres will be improved with landscaping, while other areas will have a more natural appearance, likely with some tree planting, some hydro seeding, with native grass and wildflower mix, etc. Additionally, they've submitted a cost estimate for over $12 million in improvements that aligns with the improvements depicted in their conceptual design. So we've verified that they intend on spending well beyond the $1.5 million requirement. And as previously mentioned in the background, the open space improvements proposal was reviewed by the Parks Commission, and a formal recommendation for approval was made to the City Council. And just really quickly circling back on next steps here, staff's going to, if it's the will of the council this evening, staff will continue to work with the developer on design and program for the Tracy Hills Community Park, including a public outreach plan. And this will also include returning to your Parks and Community Services Commission for approval of a community park master plan. So with that, I know I covered a lot of information here, but I'd like to just briefly remind you of the action requested tonight. It's on the screen. This concludes my presentation, and I'm going to open up for any questions.